Hello dear children, I welcome you in today's English class. Let's start this video where we left in the previous one. From here we have to start. One evening he came home with a small bundle of notes saying he had just sold a book to a publisher. You know, Anil was not earning in a proper way. His means of earning was writing. So he did not have a set income. So one night he came, one evening he came with a small bundle of notes, and even he was so simple, he showed it to Hari Singh and he told him that he sold one book and that is why he got that amount. At night I saw him tuck the money under the mattress, and at night Hari noticed that he was keeping that money under the mattress, meaning he had seen the bundle, he had note of bundle, and he had seen the place where he had kept without lock, without any key. Nothing is needed. I had been working for Anil for almost a month, and apart from cheating on the shopping, had not done anything in my line of work. See how he was doing cheating with Anil? That every time whenever Anil was sending him to market, he was earning 1 rupee profit. So this was the cheating he was doing. Rest of other, he did not make any money, though he had completed 1 month in Anil's house. Anil had given me a key to the door and I could come and go as I pleased. He was the most trusting person I had ever met. Though it was not very difficult for him to cheat Anil, because Anil had complete faith in him. Moreover, Anil had given his house keys also to him. So every time, whenever he wanted, he could cheat him. But for 1 month, he did not do any major thing with Anil. And that is why, but the problem was that Anil believed on him so much. And that is why it was not very easy for him to cheat with him. And that is why it was so difficult to rob him. It's easy to rob a greedy man because he can afford to be robbed. But it's difficult to rob a careless man. Sometimes he does not even notice he has been robbed. And that takes all the pleasure out of the work. So here the narrator Hari is saying this was the main problem which was occurring in his way to rob Anil, because Anil was so careless. And he said that it was easy to rob a greedy man because a greedy man will always be alert, and he could get the idea about how much amount he was being cheated with. But Anil was so careless person, and if you rob such careless person, maybe he would not notice about it, and it used to take all your pleasure of cheating with him. So this way, and Anil was the most trusting person. This word is very important. Anil believed him so much, and if somebody believed on you so much, and it becomes very difficult for you to cheat with. Well, that's time. It's time I did some real work. See, dear children, what is the real work? His real work is to cheat. This is the real work he knew. It's the time to do some real work, I told myself. I am out of patience. Practice. He said, now it is the time, it was the time he should do some real work. Real work means here stealing, cheating. Otherwise, maybe he would forget his real job. And if I don't take the money, he will only waste it on his friends. After all, he does not even pay me. See, we can see that Ruskin Bond, the writer, had given such a nice, that development to the story, that Hari knew it, that he was not doing a good thing to cheat such trusting person like Anil. But he is giving reasons. First, he gave reason that if he will not steal, he would be out of practice. Second, that he should do something. Moreover, he was not paying anything to him. So 1 month he worked for him and he did not pay. And if he is cheating with him or robbing him, he was not doing anything wrong. Though in his heart, he knew it very well that cheating with such trusting man was not good. Anil was asleep. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony and fell on the bed. That night, for Anil, it was also just like an ordinary night like other nights. He just slept. But for Hari, it was going to be important night when he is planning to steal. I sat up on the floor considering the situation. He realized the situation that Anil was sleeping. The bundle of notes were under his mattress. Now it was his turn to do the real job. If I took the money, I could catch 10:30 express to Lucknow. Slipping out of the blanket, I crept up to the bed. He made his complete planning that after stealing the money, he would directly go to railway station and 10:30 train to express to Lucknow he would catch, and then there would be no chance to be caught. So he made all these planning, and by just busy in his planning, he crept, and in a creeping way he reached to the bed of Anil. Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined. Even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. See, Anil, when he reached to Anil's place where he was sleeping, he noticed his innocent face. There was no mark on his face. Even he was 10 years younger to Anil, still so many marks were there on his face, and especially the marks were scars. Because he was a thief and he would have encountered so many struggle in his life of stealing. That's why he got all these marks. All these marks were showing the unrest which was prevailing in his life. My hand slid under the mattress searching for the notes. When I found them, I drew them out without a sound. Then he crept his hand under the bed and he tried to find the note. And the moment he found them, he drew out without a sound. That is very, very important for him. Without creating any sound, he took out that a bundle of notes. Anil sighed in his sleep and turned to his on his side towards me. I was startled meaning shocked here, and quickly crawled out of the room. But suddenly Anil felt something, and he turned towards his side, and this made Hari Singh extremely shocked, and he left the room. And his modus operandi was to catch 10:30 Lucknow Express and disappeared from that place for all. When I was on the road, I began to run because he became so nervous. So when he came on road, he started running. I had the notes at my waist, held them by the string of my pajamas because he did not have any pocket. And he could not keep the notes in his hand. It could be dangerous. So he kept that note tying with the string of his pajama. I slowed down to a walk and counted the notes. 600 rupees in 50s. Now he wanted to consider the amount. How much what was the amount he could steal from Anil's house? He counted, they all were 50 rupees notes, and the total amount was 600 rupees. And you know, dear children, when this book was written, 600 amount was a good amount. I could live like an oil rich Arab for a week or two. He knew it. With that amount, he could enjoy a good and peaceful life like a Arab, meaning this is a way to say that it was a very good amount even to spend 1 week like a rich person. When I reached the station, now half of the planning was absolutely executed the way it was planned. He had the money, now only the left part was to run away with that amount.
So he reached the station. I did not stop at the ticket office. I had never bought a ticket in my life, but dashed straight to the platform. Now, when he reached to the station, as he was a thief and he was in habit of doing, you know, without ticket journey. So this time also he is planning to do the same. He directly reached into the railway station without purchasing the ticket. So dear children, today we will do this much only. Thank you.